Our university librarian, Dr. Nimaichand Saha. We are about to start our second day of
Our audio is bit slow. Audio is not.
Is it okay now?
A little bit.
So with the permission of the chair, our university librarian, Dr. Nimaichand Saha, we are about to start our second day of the 3-day special session. So today we are having with us Dr. Kaushik Ghosh, who is the in charge of journal section, and he is very popular among the Vishwavarti fraternity. So I welcome you all to this second day of the session, and Dr. Kaushik Ghosh is going to highlight about the Vidwan, which is a premier database of profile of scientists and researchers and other faculty members working at leading academic institution and other research and development. So hope all of you will enjoy this session. And before we are going to start, I am giving the feedback link for the day one, which was yesterday by our university librarian, Dr. Nimaichand Saha. There were 169 participants, but we have received only 52 feedback form. So I request all the participants to kindly fill up the feedback form of the day one, that is yesterday, about the Urkund, and enjoy the session by Dr. Kaushik Ghosh. Welcome you all. May I request Dr. Kaushik Ghosh to please start your session?
Thank you, ma'am, so for your nice introduction. And at the outset, good morning to all of you. So as you know, today's lecture session topic is registration in Vidyan database as well as the earrings. So first of all, I thanks to the library authority, basically the librarian, university librarian, like Nimaichand Saha, for giving me this such kind of opportunity to furnish a few information and hands-on training on Vidyan as well as the earrings. So my deliberation already today, I am divided into two segments. First segment with the literature part, few write-up through the PPT, and after completion of the few theoretical part, I will demo through the hands-on training directly from the Vidyan database as well as the earrings database. So let us start. So registration in Vidyan database, and I'll show you later earrings also, because those earrings and Vidyan is the related to each other. So without Vidyan, so the credential of the earrings is not possible. So the background picture is the headquarter of the InfibNet, Ahmedabad. I start my first slide with the homepage of the InfibNet building, because of the all such kind of digital initiatives. So hopefully audible and visible both.
Yes, it is clear. Kaushik, go ahead.
Okay. So because all such kind of digital initiatives taken by the government of India, like Vidyan, like earrings, like Shodh Ganga, Shodh Gangotri, Shodh Shuddhi, EPG Pathshala, and many more, all are controlled by the information library network, and headquarter is the Ahmedabad. And it is the sister concern of the UGC. So this is the just few lines on the InfibNet Center, because all such kind of digital initiatives, basically these popular services and maintained and controlled by them. Information Library Network Center is an autonomous inter-university center of the University Grant Commission of India. It is a major national program initiated by the UGC in March 1991. It becomes an independent Indian university center in June 1996. That's why we may call this the sister concern of the UGC as well as the MHRD. And InfibNet is involved in modernizing university libraries in India using the state-of-art technologies for the optimum utilization of the information. And InfibNet is set out to be a major player in the promoting scholarly communication among academicians and researchers in India. So I have already mentioned before, there are lots of major initiatives taken and controlled and maintained by the InfliNet Center. I am just furnishing few important. And apart from this, there are lots of major initiatives. That's why they are already the leader at present by the on digital initiatives. So few, I am categorically in few, that is consortia, open access initiatives, project and consultancy. And in case of consortia, hope you are all familiar with the Shodh Sindhu and Shodh Shuddhi. And open initiatives, that is the InfoPort, IR InfliNet, Shodh Ganga, Shodh Gangotri, and project and consultancy, NIRF, very important terminology today now, and EPG Parsala, Vidyan database, meetings, Vidya Mitra, and many more. And in case of the NIRF and any other and any other consultancy agency, those who are maintain such kind of ranking in among the different universities, they follow the Vidyan database as well as the NIRF. So that's why these are the I am mentioning before going to my theme. So what kind of initiatives taken by us? So if we going back 1 year back or 1.5 year back, our credential in Vidyan was very poor. After the able leadership of our university librarian, Dr. Nimaichand Saha, we, on behalf of the Vishwabharati Library Network, taken so many initiatives to among our stakeholders. What kind of initiatives? At present, we have already circular 5 such kind of notification. Not only the notification, along with the write-up, link details, and Irin's different academic IDs details. And not only we end through only circular, we have taken so many special sessions among the different faculty members, among the different bhavano, one bhavano. And we have now the position of Vidyan as well as the Irin's is now at Vishwabharati is a healthy position. So I am giving few important notification from us. So this is our initiatives. Without initiative, it is not possible to increase the UC statistics as well as the increase the such kind of enriching the registration. So these are the initiatives taken by the Vishwabharati Library Network. So what kind of initiatives taken by the UGC? And in 5th November, UGC already furnished one notification on Vidyan as well as the IRINS. And this is very crucial for the faculty members. I will read out. So as you are aware, very important, that's why I am furnishing the particular line by line. As you are aware, one of the recommendation of national education policy is to develop a system of mentorship by distinguished and retired faculty. The Ministry of Education has conveyed by the communication dated 23rd September 2020 that in order to have a comprehensive database of distinguished teachers, all the higher education institutes and their faculties need to register on Vidyan portal and IRINS, that is Indian Research Information Network System, both maintained by Information and Library Network Center in FibNet. I have already mentioned before. As inter-university center of the UGC, only those very important line, I'm reading one important line. Only those institution which are registered on IRINS and only such faculty who are registered on Vidyan portal will be considered for funding by UGC or Ministry of Education. So very important line for the faculty members and as well as the institution too. In view of the above, all higher education institution and faculty are requested to register on Vidyan portal and IRINS on InfliNet at the earliest. With the initiatives taken by us at present, in case of Vishwabharati, IRINS as well as the Vidyan, our registration is now very healthy today. So what is the Vidyan? This is called the expert database. Why we called it is expert? Because all the faculty member and the research scholar they are belongs from different fields, so they are the experts. So Vidyan is the premier database of profiles of scientists, researchers, and other faculty members working at the leading academic institution and other research and development organization involved in teaching and research in India. So the database developed and maintained by the Information Library Network Center, InfibNet, I have already mentioned before, it provides important information. Why it is important? It provides important information about the expert background, contact address, experience, scholarly publication, skill, accomplishment, researcher identity, etc. The database would be instrumental in selection of panels of experts for various committees, task force established by the ministries and government establishment for the monitoring and evaluation purpose. So we can say this is a very important for the academic and research development purposes. Objectives of the Vidyan. So one can quickly and conveniently provide information about the expert to peers, prospective collaborators, funding agencies, policymakers, and research scholars in the country. So to create information exchange and networking opportunities among the scientists, to identify peer reviewers for articles and research proposal, to establish communication directly with the expert who possesses the expertise needed by them, because all their communication address along with the email address and the mail ID and along with the correspondence number is available in the database. So discover prospective collaborators for an ongoing research project. So very objectives have been clear to you. So this is the screenshot of homepage of the Vidyan database. I will show you later with the direct through online demo. So this is the homepage, because before actually already few, almost all the faculty members have their completed their registration, but it is not possible to complete your database in a one day. It is an ongoing process. So it will take few time. So few of the faculty members have completed their registration fully, and few of the faculty members, because in case of the Vishwabharati, that's a Nimaichandsa High University, I mean, is the nodal officer of Vidyan. So from the nodal officer point of view, we can watch what is the complete and incomplete, and any it is the visible from the Vidyan point of side of view also. So we can say, and our humble request to you all the faculty members and the research scholar, those who are not yet registered, so please go ahead for registration after today's session. And those who are not completed their full registration, so please complete with today's demonstration. I will show you how to update your Vidyan database one by one. And there is another facilities. Hopefully all the faculty members having their academic identity, like research scholar, COFAS ID, etc. So you need not copying and need not typing or manually add one by one. And there is a possibility to import and export facilities. I will show you during my live demo. So how to import and export your publication from research Google Scholar to Vidyan. So I will show you later. So with the example of my account, it is not possible. If we today, my demonstration is the physical mode, I will try to incorporate one new Vidyan database by one. But today is the online version. I will show from my registration, because my user ID and password in my hand. So I will show you the online demo through my Vidyan. So this is the registration part after successfully, very, very simple registration. After successfully completion your registration, then logging. And after logging, then you have to updating your all kind of data one by one. So this is the homepage of screenshot of the homepage of the Vidyan. So why Vidyan? So I have already mentioned the objectives, but a few important points. So why Vidyan? So discover potential collaborator for research proposal review and interdisciplinary research project. Showcase credential, expertise, skill, and professional achievements of faculty, scientists, organization to the peer group. And connect within focus areas and geographic expertise. integrate with external academic identity and other sources to generate bio sketches or the CV for research reporting purposes. And very important line, because if we updating our Vidyan registration or Vidyan database, there is a provision for ready-made CV. Immediate, you can download your updated CV from Vidyan. So this is the very unique feature, another unique feature of the Vidyan. So who can join? These are the who are the stakeholders? Awardees, national, international awardees and citation laureates, postgraduate and expert having a postgraduate and doctoral degree in their respective subjects with 15 years of professional experience, professor, all kinds of academics like that, from assistant professor to associate professor, professor, senior scientist, administrator, equivalent, and many more, and research scholars too. So this is the homepage of the screenshot of my page. I will show in my letter with the online demo. So these are the categories and these are the different profile segment. You have to update this particular profile one by one. As you enriching your profile progress will be reaching automatically 100%. So there are different kinds of profile. That is the personal information. I'll show you during the live demo what kind of information you need. Expertized information, experience from your starting point. So one professor starts his journey from assistant professor. So your experience starts from the assistant professor, then associate professor, then professor in such a way. Education qualification, honors and different awards, doctoral thesis awarded. It is applicable for the faculty. Informal Library Association, Indian Library Association, Indian Association of SL Library Information Centers. This is such kind of professional bodies and the membership in different committees. Different faculty members are now the committee members of the different members of the different committee in university also. So you have to incorporate this such kind of information, research project and publication part. So publication part, I will show you direct demo how to export and import from your Google Scholar. So these are the profile progress. Automatically your profile progress reaching 100% as soon as you updating data. So this is the inner side of the Vidyan database. So it is the another view of the inner side of the Vidyan database. So this is the publication area. So this is the publication along with the year, along with the your co-author, and this is the publication chart, etc. So, and this is the academic identity. So there's the, I have already mentioned before, there are different kinds of academic identity, and this academic identity is mandatory field in case of the hearings. Suppose I have no credential in COPAS, but I have no credential in archiving. But this is the mandatory field. You have to create your such kind of academic identity with zero credential. And during our notification, we will already circulated this academic identity along with the URL. Very simple to create the academic identity. And all such kind of notification is available in our university website as well as our library website too. So any can watch our notification along with the such kind of academic identity along with the links, all are available. So this is the basically Vidyan site, and few slides I will show you for the earrings, then I will go to the direct demo. So earrings, actually the last couple of few months ago, Nimaida already created with these earrings, and these earrings represent as a whole in university. Your individual credential converted in earrings as a whole in as a university. So our position is now very good. So what is the earrings? Earrings is the web-based research information management service developed by the InfliNet Center. The portal facilitates the academic and research development organization and the faculty members, scientists to collect, curate, and showcase the scholarly communication activities and provides an opportunity to create the scholarly network. The ERINS is available as free software as the service to the academic and research development organization in India. So the ERINS would support to integrate the existing research management system, such as HR system, course management, grant management system, institutional repository, open and commercial citation database, scholarly published, etc. It has integrated with academic identity such as ORCID ID, COPAS ID, Research ID, Microsoft Academic ID, Google Scholar ID for ingesting the scholarly publication from various sources. Automatically, your data fetching from this mentioned academic identity. So, what is the benefit of the stakeholders? There are different kinds of stakeholders like scholar, like faculty, like administrator. In case of the scholar, what is the benefit? It provides immense support to find mentors or advisor for their research in the respective domain. It provides scholarly metadata related to research interest of faculty members, research focus of the department and school. It helps the scholar to locate courses in their subject interest and research focus of the department and organization. This is the very benefit on behalf of research scholars. So what is the benefit for the faculty members? It supports the faculty members to showcase their research contributions to the peer group. It provides more significant exposure for their research contribution to the international community and brings finding opportunities from the national and international agencies and improve the research metadata quality and reduce the repetitive data entry for various assessment system. So benefit of administrators. It enables the administrator to build research reports, performance assessment, and research impact analysis. Strategically analyzes the research progress for better decision making on funding, faculty assessment, and source allocation. Helps the internal quality assurance cell and National Institute of Ranking Framework. I have already mentioned before regarding the NIRF ranking. So these are the benefit of the stakeholders. What is the key feature of the ERINS? So in case of the discovery, key research area and research progress of the school departments and the faculty members, we can know from this discovery point of view in ERINS and faceted search facility with number of filters to find expert and their contribution. There is a so kind of filtering option also to narrow down your search. It is one kind of discovery service also. So in case of the API, import publication from academic identities such as Microsoft Academic Search ID, Google Scholar ID, Researcher ID, and COPAS ID, and ORCID. And what is the visualization? That is a very important part of the visualization. Networking of faculty through co-author network, map of science network, and graphical presentation on productivity of the department and individual faculty member. So another important key features in respect of the research impact. Altmetric from social media such as Facebook, Twitter, and Mendeley. Citation from COPAS, cross-reference, and the link to open access article through impact story. And linking, ERINS and the linking with the Vidyan. So during our notification, we have already mentioned to take part in the ERINS and linking with Vidyan, as well as to update the database of the Vidyan. Stakeholders are requested to send the requisite information through the Excel sheet. So this Excel sheet is available in Vidyan database also. And this Excel sheet is also available in our different notifications circulated before. So without this such Excel data sheet, it is not possible to envisage the ERINS. So for your kind information, I am furnishing again the different link along with the URL. So this is the Vidyan registration link. You can click and you may proceed. And these are the different academic identity, that is the ORCID ID along with the URL, research ID along with the URL, COPAS ID along with the URL, Google Scholar along in the URL. Those who are having the Gmail ID, hope you are all with the Google Scholar ID also. So Microsoft Academic ID. You can click and proceed for registration. Very simple procedure. So for registration of different academic identity. So now the time for live demo. So this is the hook. It is visible, na?
Yes, it is visible.
Okay. So this is the homepage of the Vidyan. So this is the online part. I will show you one by one, but due to the time constraint, it is not possible to explore everything. I'll show you few important feature of Vidyan. So first registration part. So registration as an expert. I have already mentioned you all individual as the expert and registered as nodal officer. This is not applicable for you. This is for our side. Nodal officer, I have already mentioned that our university librarian, Dr. Nimaichand Santa, is the nodal officer from university, from Vishwa Bharati point of view. So you can click the register at expert. So you have to fill this metadata field, very simple. Select the title, whether it is the professor or doctor or Mr. or SMT, etc., according to your need. So this is the first name, this is the last name. So date of birth, so email address, those who are belong from the basically the Vishwa Bharati, please furnish your email ID under Vishwa Bharati domain. And this is for your kind another information that the faculty member and the basically the scholar, those are not yet received the email ID under Vishwa Bharati domain, please send a mail to the in charge computer center and request mail to them. They kindly arrange to provide me the email ID under Vishwa Bharati domain, because few of the most of the research scholars send us, please give our Vishwa Bharati mail ID, but it is not our part. The mail ID under Vishwa Bharati domain is the under custody of the in charge computer center. So this is the email ID and your password. You may select your password and the confirm password. So select the organization. You automatically Vishwa Bharati, it will be showing. Select your department if you show the Vishwa Bharati. So these are the following department. Automatically you may select your department, select your designation according to your need, month of joining, year of joining, and this is the special character, and submit registration, and it will take only 1 minute for registration. After completion of the registration, you have to go logging. It is also here logging as expert. So I have already mentioned before, I will show you from my Google, from Vidyan database due to the online demo. So if it is the physical mode, I will show you one of your newly data. So you can go through that. So I'll enter to the Google. So this is the inside of the my already almost completed my page. So I will show you one by one what is how to proceed. So this is the you may reset your password later also. So there is an option also. So I will show you later the how to download the CV. So first you have to edit expertise. So you can belong in which category. This is the expertise different field. This is the main 10 category in agriculture science, arts, humanities, biological science. You may select first. As a library professional, we are belong from the social science. That's why I put here the social science department. Then according to your choice, your subject, I incorporate here the library information sign and brief information. You may proceed according to your a few words. So then you may save. This is the expertise. And then personal information. You may click the personal information. Automatically during your registration, it will be automatically filled up of personal information. So personal information, basically your prefix, your name, first name and last name, your date of birth and your gender. So then save. You may proceed one by one. So after enriching your database, your profile progress automatically enriching towards 100. So this is the another information for the contact information. So I will show you what is the contact information. First, you have to put your mobile number, then your department, then the university, then automatically your country, automatically your state, this is the district, your PIN number, and your URL in case of Vishwabharati, your Vishwabharati University URL is your URL. So this is the contact information after completion. And any time you may edit letter, if you may edit correction by edit information by submitting the button edit. So this is the contact information. So this is the personal progress. This is the expertise progress. Then experience. So experience, you may start from basically in case of the faculty member. So you may start from the assistant professor in Vishwabharati or your earlier organization too. So you may edit your experience letter. You may add your information letter. So in such a way, you may proceed. So I start my journey in such a way. So this is my experience. So I start my journey from 2000. So that's why I start and then add one, then add another, then add another. In near future, I have to add for necessary information if required. So these are the experience category. So in case of educational qualification, you start from the UG. UG up to PhD or postdoctoral, et cetera, by adding one by one. So like now you are the UG, then PG, then you have already created a Vidyan database. And after completion, your PhD, you may add information. So add in such a way that is, it is the PhD, this is the institution name. Automatically, if you click the V, Vishwabharati will come here. And if your institution will not come, you may add your institution manually too. This is your subject, and this is year of awarded, or this is year of passing. You may add your qualification. And after reaching your qualification, here this academic profile progress will automatically reaching towards 100. And this profile score will enrich accordingly. So another important educational qualification. So honors and awards. Most of the faculty members and the administrators and the scholars and the library professional have different awards and honors. So you may add one by one. Or so in from honors and awards, there are two different ways of incorporating your data. One is manually add one by one. If we click add manually, then see data field you have to fill up. That is awarded year, that is name of the award, and awarded by in which organization. Then save and click again. So that you have lots of awards. So not possible to go manually. If your soft copy is available and converted this soft copy in CSV mode, like you have your Word file, but you have to arrange your soft copy in three categories. one by one, 1, 2, 3, 4, and converted your word into CSV. And then CSV, you may import your CSV honors and awards. It is applicable those who are having almost more credential. So if you have only 2 or 3 or 5 or 10, you may proceed manually. So this is the two options. You may add your credential from starting honors and awards or manually or automatically import. So this then the next doctoral thesis guided. This is applicable in case of faculty member. So there is a two such kind of option also, add manually and export. What kind of data here? Only four fields is available. Like one faculty member under his or her supervision, awarded many scholars. So only 4 fields you have to fill up. It is applicable only for the faculty member and the library professional and few administrator, those who are entitled as a supervisor. So name of the researcher, first you have to write your name of the researcher, then title of the thesis, then institute, in which institute it belongs, whether it may be Vishwabharati or the Bardhaman or the North Bengal University, and year of award. Then save, and it will be automatically enriching your doctoral thesis guided field. And one by one, you may add another, you may proceed. And there is also automatic import also. So if your data is automatically collected in a soft copy version in Word, but automatically from Word version, it is not possible to import. So import and export facilities through the CSV version. So you may convert your Word version by online software from Word to CSV, and you may automatically add your credential through import facilities. And these import facilities, I will suggest to you, it is applicable basically for the publication, because publication is huge number, but this doctoral thesis or the award and awards, it is not in a huge number. That's you may proceed manually. Membership bodies. So these are the few important membership bodies. I have already mentioned that in case of the library and information science, just most of the library professional having the live member of the YASLI, Bengal Library Association, Indian Library. So you may add your credential in professional organization and membership in such a way by add one by one or export through CSV. So these are the membership and professional body. And I have already mentioned that according to your updation, so your profile progress automatically reaching towards 100. So membership in different committees. Most of the faculty members under the Vishwabharati having different member of the chairperson of the defined committee. So you may proceed your credential in case of the membership in different committee in such a way. So it will be reflection in CV. I will show you later how to create our latest CV. Last few months, a couple of days ago, our university authority notified to us, please send your CV so that we can harness your CV in case of the library professional, CV in faculty member, CV in the administrator, in our library, in our university website before NAC. So those who are updated Vidyan database need not require any separate CV. So another important research project, this is applicable for the faculty members. You may proceed according to by add manually or import through soft copy through the CSV mode. So this is the patent. So those who are having a patent, you may add according to by add manually or through import your soft copy. So very important for the publication part. So I will show you how to fail, because your public essay, and it is not possible because one faculty member having more than 100 credential in publication in different mode, whether it may be conference proceeding or the book or the chapter in the book or the article proceedings and many more, not possible to add manually. It will take another 1 month or 2 months. If your credential in publication is available in Google Scholar, directly import your publication from Google Scholar to Vidyan for 1 minute. So different, but those who are having a manual mode, you may proceed at manually. So first you have, if you are manually, you have to select what kind of publication, whether it is a conference proceeding publication, it is the book publication, is the chapter in book chapter publication, or is the journal article, or the proceedings. First you have to select in case of a manually, then add. And what kind of feature? So add. So work the type. First you have to select your type. I have already mentioned that article, conference. Then if it is the journal article, so title of the publication, you have to type the title of the publication, name of the journal, name of the year, name of the author, URL, DOI, in case of the journal, it is mandatory field, the volume, page number, editor, publisher, then save, then add again. And you may proceed one by one manually, or in case of export. So I have already, so this is the different version. I will show you. In case of the other import facility, you need CSV version, like Excel format, CSV format. But in case of publication, you need only the BibTeX format. Google Scholar is also available in the BibTeX format. I will show you. I will show you from my Google Scholar how to import my publication into Vidyan. So this is the my Google Scholar. This is my Google Scholar page. So I have already incorporated before, but just I will show the step. So very important for you. So how to import from Google Scholar. So this is my Google Scholar and these are my publication. So show more, these are my publication. If you need only one or two title, because I have already fetching all title and converted to in the Vidyan, I did not require all. You may select only one by two, one or two. Or if you select all, if you select all titles and converted these Google Scholar from the Vidyan, then you have to click the export. First, open your Google Scholar, then select your required title, whether it may be individual title or all, you may click accordingly, then export. Click the export button, and there is the different format facilities, BibTeX format, EndNote facilities, RefMan, and CSV. But in case of publication in Vidyan, you need to convert it in BibTeX format. So select the BibTeX format. And this is the your publication in BibTeX format. The publication is available in your Google Scholar, and this publication is converted in your BibTeX format. Then you have to select this publication. So please save as. This is the citation of K. Ghosh. This is the name of the file. So save in desktop. So I will save the my all publication from Google Scholar in BibTeX format and save as desktop. So save it. So then you go to the again Vidyan and publication add by import BibTeX. Click the import BibTeX. server at BibTeX browse. BibTeX then browse. Okay, fast. Then BibTeX then browse, and my publication lying at desktop where it is a citation of Pagos. So select your BibTeX format and open. But if I submit, my publication will automatically repeat. So I am cannot submit it now because all the publication already converted into Vidyan database. So you have to submit and automatically your all publication data converted within a minute into Vidyan. So very simple. If any question, I will show you again. Hope it is over. It is clear, hopefully.
So yes, it is very clear.
Okay. So in such a way, you are enriching your all publication by simple way. So this is the very publication part, and another important part. So this is the publication, and automatically your profile progress gradually increase towards 100, and your profile score automatically reaching towards 10. So another important academic identity I have mentioned before, this particular academic identity is mandatory field in case of urines. Without having your zero credential, please create your academic identity and just put your ID here and save. So these are the my academic identity, and automatically your credential fetching from here to earrings. And if you have any problem to create your academic identity, follow our notice. All the URL of mentioned academic identity is given here. So in such a way, you can enrich your profile progress and enrich your Vidyan data and enrich your individual credential converted to earrings by sending the Excel format. So this is the PDF, the download CV. So like I need my updated curriculum vitae. So you may download the CV. And this is your ready-made CV page. Okay. Time is 11:55. So this is the basically important part of Vidyan, and you may watch that at present 932 Vidyan registration from the same organization, that Vishwa Bharati, already completed. And couple of few years ago, the Vidyan registration number below 100. Now the number is 932, and almost all the credential converted in earrings. So I will show you few important feature of earrings from Vidyan to earrings. So this is the earrings. This is the homepage of the earrings. So this is the instant. This is the profile, number of profiles of Indian universities. This is the publication, this is the citation, this is the allmetric mention, and this is the category in different stakeholders. So I will show you. I will show the earrings instant. So in case of Vishwa Bharati, so you may select any organization in case of Vishwa Bharati or other organization by select this way, or go directly from here. So all the universities are arranged alphabetically. So in case of Vishwa Bharati, you may go directly because Vishwa Bharati stands V, alphabetically V stands towards last page. Otherwise you may select the Vishwa Bharati because first select the state, West Bengal. Select the organization to the central university. So in West Bengal, this is the Vishwa Bharati is the only central university. Automatically Vishwa Bharati will come here. This is the Vishwa Bharati. Select the organization. So just select the West Bengal, then Central University. This is the page of Vishwa Bharati. So if we click the visit of Vishwa Bharati at a glance, we may watch the different credential department wise. So these are the faculty profiles of Vishwa Bharati. So total 700 credential have already enrolled out of 923. So our humble request to send your Excel sheet with fill up your requisite data to us so that we are enriching our IRINs. And IRINs represent the university. IRINs, most of the few agencies have their, they maintain their framework without visiting the university. They are arranged the ranking from this such kind of IRINs or Vidyan database for our university website. So in case of ranking and is in case of different, I have already mentioned the different objectives of the IRINs. So very important for us. So these are the, so you may select department wise, you may individually also, and this is as a whole, the picture of the age index as a whole. So this is the picture of the age index and this is the publication as a whole university and this is the department wise credential. At present we saw that physics is the top here, age index 105, citation 65,214. And cross reference citation 49,000. So at present, physics department represent IRINs in top. And these are the other department also. These are the other departments you may watch by own. So this is the citation. This is the cross ref citation. So I will show you the publication in physics. So this is the topmost physics. This is the another leading. Chemistry also represent the top, near about top. This is the another important of integrated science also, their credential is too good. So in such a way, as a whole university, so you may download this picture and download PDF format, download different format also. So, and this is the represent of the university in different ways as age index, as publication, as citation, as cross reference in such a way, and they are the individual credential also. So you may watch here department wise also, you may watch here faculty profile individual wise also, and you may watch here the article wise also. The very user friendly and good software too. So now Vishwa Bharati is leading towards top in other universities also. And these are the basically few important part of the IRINs. So IRINs and Vidyan is very related and linking from Vidyan to IRINs is very important. So that's why during our notification and so many initiatives taken by us as well as the MHRD, we are now enriching the IRINs database too. So these are the my today's basically few deliberation, hands-on training as well as the literature write-up and deliberation. So may I request our university librarian, because he's the master of the Vidyan and the IRINs also, he's the nodal officer too. You may, Nimaida, may I request please add something if I skip few important points.
Okay. So, Sabath, what do you like to go? Whether we will take up the question or all, you allow me to say something.
Sir, you can add your views first, then you can take the question answer after that.
Okay. Kaushik, you just stop sharing.
Okay, as you are.
See, most of the things have been covered by Dr. Ghosh, my colleague, and I just let me show something. Let me show you something. What is the lacuna we are facing in case of this, you know, Vidwan registration and linking with IRINs like that? See, this is a simple thing. That anyone can view his or her own academic contribution through Vidyan. And let me say a line, why this Vidyan is so important? Simply because, let's say, this is the formal platform, database, channel of Government of India, from where our Ministry of Education, our Prime Minister, they are taking data to represent outside the Indian scenario that what is the Indian higher education status, how it is hangover, how it is running over, what is the status of research like that. So once, if we are not able to enroll ourselves, your contribution will not be able to focus by Government of India in rest of the country. This is the number one. And number two is that by participating in the Vidwan, many of you have a misconception that I have a Google Scholar account, Nimaida, why do I need to go again Vidwan? See, Google Scholar maintained your citation report based on only those publications which are full text available in open access mode. Let me repeat again. Google Scholar basically indexed your publication, those are available full text in open access mode. Means for that full text article, one need not pay any money, either any publishers or to author directly. So, you know, many of our publication, whatever may be the number, that may not be available in the open access mode as full text. Therefore, the Google Scholar is not the mirror of your full academic contribution. Google Scholar only replicates the open access availability. And Vidwan is one step ahead of Google Scholar, and that is why in case of registration of Vidwan, you need to create another 5 ID. That is ORCID, Scopus, Microsoft Academic, Researcher ID, and Google Scholar 2. So once you put up in the left panel of the Vidwan registration database, then this will a complete configuration of your data. And hope you have understood from Dr. Kaushik's presentation that Vidwan is not the full text database. It is only the bibliographic database. You may give the author, title, name of the journal, its issue number, volume number, like that. Not the full text. And whenever and wherever your paper is going to be cited by some of the people, which are available in those 5 databases, right from Google Scholar to this Scopus, in backend it is Pavlon, and then, you know, ORCID, Microsoft Academic ID, and Researchers ID. Basically, in a study, UGC had traced out that these are the 5 core component or 5 core database where we have actually enlisted our publication or indexed our publications, done by several well-known publishers. So this is the foremost thing. Then Let me just show you, many of my colleagues and scholars, they have just registered since 5th notification, 6th notification, library is hung up in the university notice, then WhatsApp, then mail. Then they are just putting their name as a token registration. Then they are not filling up any data. Then what is happened? Right now, I will show you that total registration from Vishwabharati is 700 plus, means 701, today's morning report. I will show you. But in Vidyan, publicly it is available, most likely 618 like that. Then why this 70 or 90 or 80 candidates registration is not publicly available? Simply because they have just registered. Neither they have created the another 5 IDs, nor they have completed their uploading information, like academic information, honors and awards, publications, research projects, research scholars guidance, and many things. So unless and until you give that things, your contribution will not be publicly available. And that is why many teachers ask me, Nimaida, I have registered, my registration ID is this, but why my ID is not publicly available? I saw my colleague, but not me. What is the reasons? So this is the reasons behind that. Now, let me just show you directly. Sabab, hope my screen is visible.
Yes, sir.
Okay. You see, this is the Vidyan homepage. Then you come bottom of this. Hope my cursor, you are visible. This is organization category. You can test by your own wherever you are. I am just taking it not as nodal officer, not as any librarian of Vishwabharati, rather Nimaida. Considering myself that I am in the Bhubandanga, or I am in the Calcutta, or I am in the Maharashtra, I am in the Bangladesh, somewhere else, wherever my position is, this is the Vidyan database which is publicly available. So, see, you see, you can click Central University since we belong to Central University. Soon after clicking here, let me come to the left hand panel. This is the designation wise. Then you see Banaras Hindu University, their total registration number is 1036, top one. Then Jawaharlal Nehru University, top second, that is 726. And Vishwabharati University, top third, having 618. What I told, that is our total registration publicly published is 618 candidates only. 618 candidates. Now, let me show you, if I take entry into my login as university nodal officer. See, here in my database, everything is clearly visible to me. By this time, this is the new 3 candidates have been registered, 1, 2, 3. Perhaps this is during a demonstration by Dr. Kaushik Ghosh, this day, because 30 minutes before, these were not there. Then my duty is simply to make approve of these 3, Dr. Sanath Roth, then Arya Sisi, and Anindya Sundar Rai, these 3. So let me just select, activate. Okay. Now you see nothing is new. Everyone is now active. So let me show you, total number of registered is 704. As I told you that earlier it was 701, after adding the 3, it is now 704. So you see, in as university nodal officer, in my database, I am able to understand and report to my honorable vice chancellor and university authority too, that we have total 704 registrants. Or candidates having registration 704. But whenever I am going to see outside my database, it is showing only 618. You see, near about 86 candidates, near about 90 candidates. So these 90 candidates, they are just mere registered themselves, not able to create any other databases, that 5 databases ID. Neither they have entered the honors and awards, their academic qualification, their administrative positions or academic positions, even not the publication uploading like that. And here, don't mix it up. You are not supposed to upload the entire full text of your database. Only you are requested to upload the list of your database. And that list, if it is available in the Google Scholar, you can download, as Kaushik shows, that BibTeX format you can download. And in the Vidyan database, you can upload from that BibTeX format. It will take 1 minute to go around. You need not pay by particular type for one by one like that. So you see, this is my pen as university coordinator, that I am found, I am showing that 704 candidate is registered, but in publicly it is available 618. And you see, Jamia Millia University, they are just fourth who are having 517, just 100. But if it is 704, then we have been upgraded by 2000, near about 200 more than this Jamia Millia. So any day, this Jamia Millia University may defeat us in terms of number. And if it had been that our all 704 candidates registered properly, then if our scale was 704, then we have just lagging behind 20 candidates from Jawaharlal University. So another 2-3 days we take to defeat Jawaharlal University, and we can come to second position in Indian Central Universities databases. So this is my humble request, and that is why many a times we found call, many a times we found individual interaction that, Nimaida, can you please help us? And see, today I'm very unfortunate to note here that only 60 to 64 candidates have joined out of many thousand candidates of scholars and teachers around 500. So this is very bad luck that we are paying time, but the academics are not very congenial to adopt this kind of session to orient themselves how to register. But many of us, even yesterday in the suggestion box, they made that, Nimaida, can you please organize one session on Vidwan? So this is the scenario. When we are organizing, you are not responding, and many a times you are just going to confused. How can I upload? How can I do like that? That things. So this is in one point. Now, let me show you. What about the irons? In addition to Dr. Ghosh, what he has saying, I am just added here one thing that he has rightly noted, that Central University and West Bengal, if you select here, it will show at the bottom only Vishwabharati. Then click this visit, and this is the Vishwabharati showcase. You see here it is 703. So all these 703 candidates, but in Vidyan it is not available 703. It is just 618 like that. So all these 90 candidates, they knew that they have not yet uploaded and they have not fulfilled the entire paraphernalia or entire decorum of Vidyan registration. So that is incomplete registration they have done. That is why their portfolio is not going there to showcase. Now, if I want to see any particular teacher's contribution, let me show expert name. Let me say Rakesh Kundu. See, this is the Assistant Professor Department of Geology. This is his profile. If anyone want to see his profile, then they may click here. See his publication. And you see citation index, H index, citations, and altmetrics. So all these things coming together, your Google Scholar cannot figurizing all these three together. You see, citation, he has 786 citation, and his personal H index is 10 and 1356 cross-reference citation. And altmetric, this is Google Plus, this is 30, then Facebook 14, then Twitter 22, then WhatsApp and any other social network site 454, and this is 208. And this is his co-authorship network. How many total co-authors he has? 479. And this is his year-wise number of publication. Okay, so you see, this is the thing. Everyone can show it. This is his experience. And mind it, you are not supposed to upload or input anything IRINS directly. Mind it, you are not supposed to anything input or data entered IDINS directly. Your duty is to upload, edit, update, enter, input anything only in Vidwan database. And since Vidwan and IDINS is interlinked, once you update something in Vidwan, soon after approval from my side as coordinator, and then our internet authority will approve, then your Vidwan and linking Vidwan and IDINS will link together. So you need not think something on IDINS updation like that. And once you're able to do it, this is the beauty of the Indian database, that this data box will come only here. And you see, he has 38 journal articles, 4 conference proceedings, out of which this 4 is full free, this 2 is also free, this 5 is again free, this 23 is closed access. So this cannot be come around in Google Scholar inbox. This is the beauty of this. And since Dr. Rakesh Kundu, you see here, he has noted his ORCID ID, Scopus ID, Researcher ID, Google Scholar ID, and then Microsoft Academic ID. As he has put up all this ID here, so his other corporate publication or paid publication is being coming here. Here paid means, don't mix it up, that he has paid journal article publication fee. To me, paid means this is the journal for which we need to pay on behalf of Vishwarthi fraternity, then only you will be able to access full text, otherwise not. And this green, yellow, and this you can say brown color like that. If you go around a website called Sherpa Romeo, there you will have different publishers. As I told you yesterday, that every publisher has their own copyright policy, digital rights management policy. That is called gold path, yellow path, brown path, white path, like that. So there is clear mandate which is linked with that world famous database, and this replica will be coming here. Now, this is the individual, anyone can see these things. Now, as Dr. Kaushik Ghosh told, that this is our university's total scenario. Many of my colleagues asked me, here you see mathematics, painting, part of one physical education, then physics is not here. But here, if you point out your screen, this is the basically the due to space crunching, physics department name is not coming here, but it is there. So physics is like that. Forget about these things. And to fill up the NAC data, many of the departmental teachers or HODs, they require the total departmental age index, how much it is. From here you can see, or better you can go here, these 3 lines. Once you click here, you just download PNG, JPEG, then download XLS. So once you click here, download XLS, just a second business to get our university, each and every department wise Excel sheet details. Let me show the file format extension of age index. Just don't share this. Okay. See, this is the administration one category, age index 0, publication 65, citation 00, cross reference 00. Likewise, agricultural economics, they have age index 1, publication 56, citation 4, then cross reference 4. So many a case we have found that someone is writing as chemistry, someone is writing Department of Chemistry, someone is write Department of Chemistry, comma, Shikha Bhavano, someone is writing Department of Chemistry, Vishwabharati. So because of this variation, you cannot get your total departmental profile in a position. That's the lacking of data input and Vidwan database. You see here chemistry, this is the 32 of their age index, then publication 1029, and their citation is 4430. 3981 is the cross reference. Then come down. That is Santali, sculpture, Shikha Satra, Silpa Sadhana, social work, soil science and agricultural chemistry, statistics, geology. So all this. Now, if I add here, drag all this field and make a summation, then I will get the total Vishwabharati's H index, how much it is. And before 1 year, it was never and quite impossible to say and to fill up the data in case of NRF ranking, that how much the total age index of Vishwavarti University as a whole. Then you see the beauty of the software itself. You all being the departmental facet, input your individual data. Then IRINS is mixed up and compiled either as a department. Then again, the data can be fetched up department wise. Then after adding this page, it will become the total Vishwavarti University age index. Then here it is number of publication, total citation, total cross referencing. And otherwise, here you can see in the top page, total we are having 8,362 publication, patent 26, out of which close access 1405, gold open access 607, green open access 104, bronze open access 53. Then this is journalistical conference proceedings, then books, chapter, others. This is the category. Then total Vishwavarti University as a whole, having citation of cross reference 57,116 and 80,031 is the citations. So this is the beauty of the Vidwan and IRINS. Don't mix it up and don't try to compare this Vidwan and IRINS with Google Scholar. Google Scholar may be considered as a facet or as a part of these things, but it is a complete incomplete database, and Google Scholar is fully based on open access path. So I think whatever Dr. Kaushik Ghosh pronounced, and in addition to this 15-20 minutes what I have told, I think now much clearer about the things on you. And those who have attended the session, please share with the experience with the other colleagues and scholars, so that our task will be easier. And my fervent appeal to all of you, please do register as much as you can in the Vidwan database. And those who have only registered, please complete your database as quick as you can, at least before NAC, so that this imbalanced data, which will be cumbersome to me to defend, why 700 registration but 618 only published? So it will be very difficult to me to defend. So to excel the quality of the Vishwavarti in general, to gain the good award, to avoid the any data imbalance, please, please and please upload your list of publications, upload your academic experience, upload your career details, upload your honors and awards details, and that five registration details. That is a very simple thing. And if you have any problem, when lockdown will be over, you can come in the Central Library. We will try to take care about the things. However, many scholars in the department and many teachers of the department, they are more than efficient than us. So you can contact with them and you can resolve the issue and register yourselves without sitting merely. Otherwise, these things will help us a lot to go around for achieving good grade in NRF ranking, NAC ranking, and also World University Ranking Framework like that, any kind of ranking. And last minute, my request to all of you that, as my colleague Dr. Sabhat Mohsin, being coordinator of the today's session, told that yesterday we found that 169 candidates attend. But we have received so far only 66 feedback. And today also, I found around 65 candidates there. And again, our day-to-day, second day's feedback link, hopefully Sabhat Madam shared in the chat box. Please do it. And also, we are having a standing feedback notice available in the library website, available in the, our university website, and we have circulated in the mail, we have circulated through WhatsApp too. So you all are requested to feedback, that general feedback, to encourage us, to enlighten us, to help us to adopt corrective measures, what we need to do best for the acceleration or for the escalation of our research activities, academic activities, even during this pandemic days. You see, pandemic may arrest our physical movement, but pandemic does not arrest our physical technical movement or technical activities. So by technical activities, we can remain live in the academic corridor, in the ranking framework, in our performance evaluation. So please, please and please, do fill up, do submit,
your feedback and help us to serve you better with these few words. Now let me hand it over to Dr. Sabhat Mohsin, today's coordinator, to pick up some questionnaire and put forward on the floor. Dr. Kaushik Ghosh is responsible to answer. If required, I can also make some addenda for answering the questions. So Sabhat, thank you for giving me this time, 20 minutes, to share my views. Now floor is over. Thank you.
We should thank our university librarian who has organized such a session one after another. I would like to congratulate Dr. Kaushik Ghosh for his nice presentation and simple step, which will definitely enhance the research productivity of the faculty as well as the research scholars. And Dr. Kaushik Ghosh has given a very simple step to which we can register to with one. And we can have a peek into his rich CV and professionally activist. We had an added lecture from our university librarian, which was like an ice on the cake. And this continuous lectures on the Vidwan and Ardenness is nothing to enhance the research productivity of the faculty and scholars. This is a kind of pool from which the visibility will increase and the faculty will be choose for different experts in different fields and scholars will be chosen for different projects. Thank you, University Librarian, Dr. Nimai Chand Saha and Dr. Kaushik Ghosh. May I request Kaushik Ghosh and University Librarian to answer a few questions. So it is very interesting that the session, during the session, so many questions has come up. I will ask to answer one by one. So one of the question which has come from Franchari Basak, she has asked that for MPhil scholar, what must be the designation sorted in the list? So,
madam, what was the designation?
She is the MPhil scholar. So she want to know, well, what kind of designation she will choose while registering in the Vidwan.
Scholar, MPhil scholar.
Okay, Sanchari, is that clear?
Shibirite has started his her designation as scholar, research scholar.
Research.
Because few of the faculty members started their journey from research scholar. In case of Rakesh Kundu too, we watched that he started his experience and start his journey from as a research. So any MPhil student or any PhD student, he or she may start her designation, write his or her designation as research.
And Shirin Shen Gupta, she is also a research scholar. So she also had the same question. So hope we have answered both the question, Shirin Gupta and Sanchari Basa. One more question from Padmani Balaram. She has asked whether if she is having an elaborated CV, so she want Kaushik Da to get it updated. So
if he send.
She want to know whether she entries will be taken in the Vidwan directly.
No, that cannot be done, Kaushik. Her actually question is that she will send you the her CV, and are you ready to upload her CV in the Vidwan database like that?
Not possible, ma'am. Not possible, ma'am. Because you have to import your data from your own account first. Then and I have already mentioned that create your soft copy data in the exact particular format, that is BibTeX format in case of the publication. So convert your all publication data into BibTeX, whether it may be Google Scholar. So soft copy you have to format first, and then according to our metadata wise, then you have to import by own. Not possible by us, because I am not incorporate your enter your account.
I was trying to ask is, I don't expect you to do for me. What I was trying to say is there any mechanism that it takes straight, because you were showing something, so I misunderstood that. That's why I'm asking to clarify. You said no, if your
ma'am, you are mostly welcome, because there is a converting process. You may convert your data from Word to BibTeX through online procedure also.
Okay.
If you type in Google, convert word to BibTeX, then automatically your word file convert to BibTeX.
And then I upload that CV, then it will get done. Is that so?
But after opening our university level, we are ready to show you how to proceed.
Okay. All right. I'll convert it and then send it.
Yes,
I mean, application is available on the YouTube also.
YouTube also.
So.
Okay. And another thing I wanted to ask you, I mean, request you, Nimaida, that I have three, by mistake, somehow it has become my three profiles. I don't know how it came. So I have one profile where I've added everything, I mean, a lot of stuff. So I wanted to save that and remove other two. And I'm not able to get in because of these confusion. So I'm not able to finish my profile. So if you can help me later with that.
Yeah, you need to send one mail to me, okay. Mentioning your ID, which you want to kept yes. as it is, and which other two you need to remove it. Then I need to send it to Delhi. They will do it. Okay.
Okay. That's okay. Thank you.
But you have to send it. Nimaida, actually, ma'am, earlier told that the enriching profile, he unable to extract the number or ID. Before it was, before she has a enriched Vidyan data, hopefully.
No, I had done, I had filled up quite a bit of things and some things was left to fill. And meanwhile, this thing happened. So that was the thing. So I don't know what is existing there now.
I see.
Nothing is visible to me, my side as nodal officer. At present, I'm just checking.
Okay.
That problem is remain as it is. So you need to mention the three IDs first, then which you want to restore and which other two you want to remove. You just send one line of mail.
You are not able to see because last time they could see three IDs, you know. That's how I can see.
PADMINIBALARAM, isn't it?
Right.
Nothing is here.
Nothing is there. Okay, wonderful. So it disappeared. Okay, fine. Thank you.
We move to another question.
Yes, please.
Another question comes from Krishna Biswas. She is asking, how can I add my research paper to my Google Scholar account from ResearchGate account? She wants to add some papers from Google Research account to Google Scholar.
Convert from Google Scholar to ResearchGate?
From ResearchGate to Google Scholar.
Conversion?
Yes, how she can add from this side to that side.
Hopefully there is a procedure to import, but I don't know whether there is a possibilities to convert his data from Google Scholar to ResearchGate. You mind that?
Actually, what she can do is that if the question is a little tricky and imbalanced, generally we used to do it link from my Google Gmail account to Google Scholar account. Once it is done, then all the free and open access paper written by that Krishna Biswas will become automatically. You need not add anything in Google Scholar separately.
Sure.
Only thing you need to add that things which are not available in open access mode, which I told earlier. So at the very outset, you have to decide which papers available in open access mode, which are not. Those papers are available in open access mode. You need not import, export type separately in Google Scholar, number one. Number two, the paper which you have uploaded in Research Scholars, uploaded means details about the paper. ResearchGate also does not contain the full text unless it is full text mode available in open access. Okay, so in that case, if any good journal papers or book chapter you have uploaded there, that details you can open side by side to mode and you can just make copy and paste author to author, then title to title, like that way will save you a time to avoid any further typing. But there is no mechanism to download the entire list of publications from ResearchGate in a BibTeX or in a CSV file or Excel file or doc file or PDF file. There is no permission. And as there is no permission to export the file format, so there is no chance of uploading in Google Scholar. Okay. This is.
Okay. question is answered, Krishna. The another question is coming from Shumudit Vishwas. He's asking, do we have to register in IRENA separately?
No.
That question already I answered. Repeatedly, I say that don't want to input anything in IRENA. You forget about anything input in IRENA. You just handle anything for input. It is in Vidwan database. Vidwan database is input, data entry, upload, everything you can do in Vidwan, and replica or output device or output database is the IRENA. IRENA is the mirror. You need not touch up anything in IRENA. Rather, you want to do it Vidwan. And you, even you do not require any separate registration in IRENA, the Vidwan registration ID automatically will be texturized in the IRENA database. The same ID number will be there. So don't worry about that.
And you have to incorporate all the academic identity in Vidyan.
Right.
Shomajit, it is clear to you? So you can.
Yes, it is clear.
You have all the lectures.
Okay, thank you.
Next question is from Shubhodeep Das. Can I publish an article to Google Scholar directly and put that in BibTeX format in Vidwan?
Bollam. Open access kina seta dekhte hobe. You have to find out whether your full text is open access mode or not. If it is open access mode, you need not any upload or any data entered there. Google Scholar automatically fetch up from your open access things. And if you want to enlist list Google Scholar, ResearchGate, this Vidwan, these all are not the full text database. This is only the bibliographic database where you need to encapsulate only the name of the contributor, article of the title of the article, title of the journal, and details things, but not the full text from 1 to 10 pages or 10 to 20 pages. Full text, what I actually want to mean, I don't know whether you are getting or not. So full text, you need not want to upload in Google Scholar, in ResearchGate, in Vidwan. These all are indexing and you see bibliographic database. Okay. And full text, for full text uploading, you can you do not upload separately. Whatever available in the full text in Google's in open access mode, automatically downloadable through Google Scholar by some other people, and through ResearchGate some other people. And through ResearchGate, if anyone love your paper to read, or prefer to read your paper, or require your paper to cite and full text, they need to send one request you through mail. Then you may give him personally, him or her personally, through mail your full text paper. This is the thing. Don't mix it up. Just try to understand full text and bibliographic database. And another one is indexing database, like Web of Science, Pavlon, Scopus, then ORCID. All these things are index database. This Vidwan, you can say also Google Scholar, ResearchGate, even LinkedIn and Academia. All these are particularly for bibliographic database. And then some others are full text database, which are maintained and coordinated by the journal publishers or any book publishers by their own. And in Vishwabharati, we are asking all the scholars and faculty members to submit their full text papers to upload in the Vishwabharati University institutional repositories, again, which is not to be downloaded by the rest of the country people, because that will be protected by the password. Once they request us, and if we think that they will use your paper by maintaining fair use doctrine and use for the academic purpose, not for commercial purpose, then only we will think whether we will send the full text or not. See, this is the matter of copyright and digital rights management issues. So don't mix it up that whether I can able to upload. You are not supposed to upload full text of paper in Google Scholar. Hope it is clear. If it is not clear, then I don't think any good and simple answer for this question.
দাদা পূজাজি একটা থ্যাংক ইউ হিমাদা একটা খুব সহজ একটা প্রশ্ন আছে সেটা বলতে পারি
হ্যাঁ
হ্যাঁ ওপেন সোর্সটা মানে কি এটা একটা প্রশ্ন ওপেন সোর্সটার মানে একটু যদি বুঝিয়ে দেন আর দ্বিতীয় প্রশ্নটা হচ্ছে যে আমি কোন এই মুহূর্তে প্যান্ডেমিকের কারণে আমি কোন একটা জায়গায় পাবলিশ কি করাতে পারি বিশ্বভারতীর কি নিজস্ব কোনো সংস্থান আছে যেখানে আমি সরাসরি আমার একটা আর্টিকেল পাবলিশ করতে পারি
না বিশ্বভারতীর নিজস্ব কোনো সংস্থা নেই সোশ্যাল ওয়ার্ক ডিপার্টমেন্টের একটা জার্নাল আছে আরেকটা পত্রিকা, আরেকটা পত্রিকা চলে খোয়াই পত্রিকা বলে, এরকম ইংরেজি ডিপার্টমেন্টের একটা জার্নাল আছে, ফিজিক্স ডিপার্টমেন্টের একটা জার্নাল আছে, সেই ডিপার্টমেন্ট তুমি যে ডিপার্টমেন্ট এটা তাদের সাথে কন্ট্যাক্ট করলে ইউ উইল গেট দ্য রাইট আনসার। আর ওপেন সোর্স কথাটা ভুল, ওপেন সোর্স কথাটা অ্যাপ্লিকেবল ফর সফটওয়্যার অ্যান্ড ইন টেক্সট ফাইল অর ফুল টেক্সট ইট ইজ কল ওপেন অ্যাক্সেস অনলি। ওপেন অ্যাক্সেস যে পেপারটা, যে পেপারটাকে ফুল টেক্সট ডাউনলোড করা যায় উইদাউট এনি থ্রেডস অফ লগ ইন পাসওয়ার্ড অর আস্কিং ফর এনি মানি লাইক দ্যাট ইজ কল ফুল অ্যাক্সেস অর ওপেন অ্যাক্সেস। ওকে, অ্যান্ড ওপেন সোর্স বেসিক্যালি সফটওয়্যার, দেয়ার আর মেনি সফটওয়্যার লাইক ইউ নো দিস জোটেরো, this Mendeley, these are the open source software where source code is free. You can download the software and you can edit your source code and customize by your need, and you can configure and install in your machine by your own. That is called source code. So open source, open access, closed source, gold path, green path, all these things are quite different. Better to go through Sherpa Romeo URL. Sherpa Romeo is a kind of website. There you will get the clear mandate, clear guideline. World-class publishers, they have their own license agreement with that Sherpa Romeo website. There you will get what is the copyright issues, what is the author's liability, what is the publisher's liability, what is the user's liability. Everything is clearly mandated there. So you can browse and have a experience from Sherpa Romeo things. We are not also master of that things, but I am taking care on Sherpa Romeo website. And from there, I am just saying all these answers because that's a very world famous URL. And which we library peoples and the academia and the technical, those who are involved in technical research writing, we all are the member there, and we are just getting input from their things. Okay.
Thank you. Sherpa Romeo.
Okay.
Can we move to another question? Yes. It comes from Shobhana Chowdhury. Sir, as a research scholar, can we actually complete the Vidwan details? Because we are not yet awarded, we do not submit our thesis. The details will be ultimately incomplete. So whether she want to know whether her data will be complete or not, because she is not, is yet a scholar.
Yes, according to her present credential, she may post it.
Okay, Shubhana. Hope we have answered your question. Next question from Divine Datta.
One more question. It's like that if I did not give all the details, then it will show on the database where Srimai sir has mentioned just right now, because it's not showing, because all the datas are not showing.
You may create your own academic identity. No need to complete your PhD. So basically your qualification, your publication, you may proceed for your academic identity.
Okay, this much will do, for this much will be enough for
soon after getting registration you are registered as research scholars, that is free from your award and other things.
Okay sir, thank you.
The success of the program, that so many questions, 6 more questions are coming, so this shows that program was so successful and all the participants are actively participating and asking the question to clear the doubts. So another question from Divayan Datta, what about the recent research scholar who are yet to publish their work? Suppose he has not yet published, so what about him?
Actually, without publication, his or her publication credential or progress will automatically going towards bottom or less. So you may proceed according to your present credential.
So Dibayan, you can register yourself, and in the meantime, if your publication,
because in case of the basically the mandatory field of ERINs in academic identity, few of the people, those who are having no zero credential in few identity. So you may just create the identity having your zero credential.
Hope it is clear to you, Dibayan. We are moving to the next question. Mihili Sweta from Sangeet Bhavan. She's asking whether we may register our profile in Vidwan by personal email ID.
Actually, I have already answered this question during my presentation, because I am requested to all the research scholar, please kind to arrange your Vishwabharati mail ID from computer department. Our suggestion is that please create your registration through Vishwabharati mail ID.
Dada, actually we are now out of station. So...
No, just you get one mail to the in charge computer center.
Okay. Thank you.
Most of the scholar already collect through mail. No need to come directly to the computer set.
Okay, Dada. Thank you, Dada.
We are moving to next question from Mo Chakraborty. She is asking whether she can give the newspaper clipping in Vidwan database.
Never. Because newspaper publication is just like essay publication. That's not any academic publication, which do not have any abstract, keywords, citation, referencing, other things. So that cannot be considered as an academic publication. So that cannot be come into this Vidwan database and Google database and Google Scholar database, and that cannot be taken into consideration for any kind of academic awardship.
We are moving to next question from Sanchari. In Vidwan designation list, there is only PhD research scholar. So I have to go for it. And there are many scholars in BBU who are faculty member in other academic institutions. Do they have to register separately under two institutions?
So there are many scholars of BBU who are faculty
members. Suppose he is faculty members also. And he is doing PhD also. So in which field they need to register?
So Nimaida.
See, actually Sanchari, your question is having two answers. Last part is having two answers. Let's say I am the research scholars of Bengali department. And of course, at the same time, I am the faculty member of Vishwabharati Bengali department. If it is your question, then answer will be you can register yourself in assistant professor ID or designation, okay, without scholar ID. And if the question is that I am the scholar of Vishwabharati and serving in a college, in that case, answer will be, since you are registered yourself with your Vishwabharati identity, so here your identity is research scholars, we will not granted as assistant professor of some other colleges. It may be that you are serving in a college which is under Barasa State University or Bankura University. So Vishwabharati do not have any right to get registered of another university, associate or assistant professor or professors like that. So we don't have anything to intervene to show other college or other university professors or academics under Vishwabharati's name. So it's never, it's very quite clear to all of us that we cannot intervene, we cannot capture any other university teachers to show our. So that's a kind of infringement. So don't think and don't mix it up. If your identity is research scholars, do register as research scholar. If your identity is assistant professor at Vishwabharati, do it as assistant professor. And if you are in dual mode, one is outside Vishwabharati and another one is inside Vishwabharati, so you do register yourself in Vishwabharati. That's very generic thing, I think. There is no doubt about that. Okay.
There are no more questions in the chat box.
Yes, time is also asked us to stop.
Yes, so I would like to congratulate all the participants also because they are one step ahead. And
request once again for feedback. Repeatedly request them for feedback submission today's, yesterday's, and also our standing feedback. There are three feedback.
Yes, we have given the feedback link in the chat box. So I request all the participants to kindly give your feedback for yesterday Urkund session, for today's Vidwan session, as well as we have a feedback link for our library overall services. So what you want your library to be, how you want your library to see. So please give your feedback so that we can enhance our services, we can enhance it, or we can modify according to your need. So your feedback and valuable suggestions are very much required, and hope all of you will definitely give the feedback, as we had 169 participants for yesterday's session, but we have received only 66 feedback. So today all the participants are requested once and once again to put your valuable feedback and suggestions for yesterday Urkund session, today's Vidwan session, as well as the overall library services.
And one more, yeah, Sabah, just a minute.
Yes,
one more request to all of you that tomorrow we have one more session, which is very, very important or, you know, pertinent to our current situation, that is called during this pandemic days. You are still in your residence. And you see, repeatedly, I have receiving mail even today in the morning during this session that, Nimaida, please, can you extend my Open Athens, extend my Open Athens ID password or active access account like that? And from, for your information, from April 1st, 21st, this year, April 1st, we have not facility of Open Athens platform, that is remote access and discovery services by using Open Athens platform. That has been expired from Vishwa Bharati. Now, in place of that Open Athens, we are now having LS Discovery, which is more congenial, more simpler, more easier, more quicker to arrest any particular resources, e-resources, digitized resources, and our Vishwa Bharati Library catalog resources too, to start. So please join tomorrow and to enlighten on that particular topic, how you can get login, how you will access Vishwa Bharati Library catalog, how you will access electronic resources, be it electronic books and be it electronic journals too. And of course, how you will access our digitized collections, means digital library. So all these things will represent before you all, none other than Dr. Sabhat Nausin, who happens to be our in charge of Abhidhamam Library, and of course, having additional charge of PSB Library. So madam will represent tomorrow. You please join to tomorrow and encourage her to make a grand success of this mission of Vishwa Bharati Library Network. And today's session also, I think you have already listened, and pass on your feedback. We don't have any pressure to that. You need to excellent, mention excellent, excellent, excellent. Don't think that. Only we request you or pressure is you to submit your actual and factual feedback so that we will customize ourselves in future course of action. So with this, now Sabhat, please to conclude the session.
Thank you, sir. So under the able leadership of Dr. Nimaida Sahab, a university librarian, and very lucid and lectures from Dr. Koshi Ghosh, we are about to finish this second day session of the 3-day special program. So all the participants are requested once again to give your valuable suggestion. Thank you, everyone.
Okay. So, Jishnu or Kaushik, those who are technically hosting the event, may I conclude or may I leave the meeting?
Okay. Just I am.